legendary Earl Scruggs invented a three-finger style of banjo playing known worldwide as Scruggs picking, which changed the way the banjo is played. Bluegrass was born when Earl added his fast, syncopated solos to Bill Monroe's band in 1945. In 1948, he and Lester Flatt formed Flatt and Scruggs, perhaps the most popular bluegrass band in history. In 1969, Earl formed the Earl Scruggs Review with his sons, electrifying bluegrass and combining it with new music forms. A three-time Grammy Award winner, Earl Scruggs is widely recognized as one of the most important pioneers of American music.
Bluegrass music really came to life, I think, when Earl Scruggs joined Bill Monroe. I thought, Lord Almighty, I didn't know nobody could play the banjo like that. I don't know where he got his notion. Maybe he invented it.
Earl is an American treasure. He's a hero of all of us that love bluegrass and old-time music. His banjo style has revolutionized the banjo.
Friendship with Earl will last as long as I live, and if he outlives me, I hope he'll still think of me as a good friend. Here's a good old song that kind of borrows the legendary character John Henry. It's called Walk On Boy. 2, 3, 4.
I was born one morning, the rain a pouring down. I heard my mammy say to my pappy, let's call him John Henry Brown. Walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. Ain't nobody in the whole wide world gonna help you carry your load.
Six-time Grammy Award winner Doc Watson established a high-speed flat picking style reminiscent of old-time fiddle tunes that became a standard in bluegrass and country music. His rich baritone voice, virtuoso picking, and unique sound, often categorized as mountain music, have helped earn Doc a reputation as an American treasure. For more than four decades, Doc has been America's most renowned and influential folk guitar stylist. Today, he often performs with his grandson, Richard Watson.
Just about the age of 10, I got me a job of working on the levee, toting water for the hard-working men. Walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. Ain't nobody in the whole wide world gonna help you carry your load.
Doc Watson is one of America's most important musicians. He understands the old style singing. He understands the old style playing. He's been an innovator. Doc's abilities to play those fiddle tunes and play them note for note like a fiddle would play it, you know, is just pretty amazing.
One day my pappy told me some advice I'd like to give to you. Son, find a good woman, be good to her, and she's gonna be good to you. Walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. Ain't nobody in the whole wide world gonna help
Doc
you
was
carry
a real hero of mine when I first saw him, first heard him play. He's got that mountain sound to his picking, and he's one of the best to keep it in that mode of sound.
Thank you.
if anyone ever should ask you, just who is that fella Brown? You can tell him I'm the boy that left his hammer smoking where he beat that old steam drill down. Walk on, boy. Walk on down the road. Ain't nobody in the whole wide world gonna help you carry your load.
Doc is the type of person that once you meet him, you feel like you've known him for years. He's just down to earth, and he's Doc Watson anytime you see him. I would like Doc Watson whether we ever played a tune together or not.
Howdy!
By the time he was 10, Ricky Skaggs had already performed with three of the most important bluegrass acts of all time, Lester Flatt and Earl Scruggs, Bill Monroe, and the Stanley Brothers. As a major country star in the 80s, he drew on his bluegrass heritage, transforming old tunes into a streak of number one country hits. In the 90s, Ricky returned to his roots with a passion by forming Ricky Skaggs and Kentucky Thunder, one of the most popular bands on the scene today. An 8-time Grammy Award winner, Ricky Skaggs has earned nearly every award in country music as a vocalist, instrumentalist, and producer.
First time I saw Ricky, we used to work up near where you were raised,
Louisa,
Kentucky, yeah. And he came out to the show. There came this little guy with his mantle and the pick, and he pick he did too. It was Ricky Skaggs.
Ricky is not only just a good mandolin player, a good bluegrass musician, he knows all kinds of music. He knows the theory of music, and yet it doesn't spoil him into wanting to play everything real fancy and all that. He plays music the way it should be played. Let's put it in plain English.
Still with what he has, he still improves. He's one of the best band leaders I've ever seen. He has one of the best bands. All of the guys are great musicians. It would take a long time to tell all the important things that Ricky has brought into show business.
Thanks, folks. Thank you very much. We'll see you a little bit later, all right? Thanks for coming.
I can't say it's a dream come true because I never dreamed anything like this would ever happen. I've played with Earl some down through the years, but to get to actually do a project with him and Doc Watson is just it's just the greatest thing, and I'm so honored and so blessed to, you know, get a chance to do this.
I thought, hey, if we can put our hearts, heads, and fingers together and our instruments together, we can come up with something pretty good for the three pickers.
When you brought up the idea, I said, let's go with that. So it was just so thrilling to get to sit down with Doc Watson and Ricky Skaggs and do what we did over there.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're fixing to have some fun now. It's called Pick Along. All right, Earl.
Pick it with you, Ricky. and lazy bones. That's where I rest my weary bones. Just a little ways ahead, there's an old farmer's shed. That's where I rest my weary bones.
I just got to say one thing here. These two men have had such an incredible impact on my life as a musician. Earl Scruggs in the banjo and bluegrass, he did it for me. It set my life going, and I know there's so many that could really thank the master Earl Scruggs, because he really took an instrument and mastered it, and encouraged so many to play. Earl, I thank you for all the hard hours and all the road miles. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Ricky. I sure appreciate that. Let me explain one thing about what I've done. It's been no problem for me at all, because I was going to pick anyway. I started playing when I was about 4 or 5 years old, or trying to, and the further I went with it, and back when I was very small, radio wasn't big then, and no TV, of course, but as time went on, and the old Maud seemed to walk faster pulling the plow stock than she used to, I decided I'd try picking the banjo instead of picking cotton up here around Shelby, North Carolina. That's where I was from. Well, so I've been at it ever since.
I'm sure glad you did, Earl. And Doc, you are you're an American hero. You're a classic. You're American treasure. And I know everybody from North Carolina is proud of you. And And folks, I think it's March next year. Doc's going to be 80 years old very soon. And I hope and pray that I can play and sing as good as Doc when I'm 80 years old. And Doc, I love you.
I wish I could play that good now.
Well, now, Earl, now wait just a minute. He's still faster than I am, Ricky. Yeah, but let me tell you something, buddy. The good Lord's been good to me. You know, if I could see, I'm going to surprise these folks. The guitar would have been a beloved thing to me, but it would have been a hobby. I'd have been a carpenter or an electrical engineer. Now, what do you think of that? Well, I love home.
Yeah. Well, let's...
But the good Lord said, Doc Watson, you're going to pick. Because that handicap got you kind of sidetracked for a few years, but
I got
out there.
Brother afar from the Savior today, risking your soul for the things that decay. Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give? Change for your soul. What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul? Mercy is calling you, won't you give heed? Must the dear Savior still tenderly plead? Risk not your soul, it is precious indeed. What would you give exchange for your soul. What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give
in exchange?
What would you give in exchange for your soul? Oh, if today God should call you away, what would you give in exchange for your soul?
That's got him.
Thank you, folks. Thank you, Doc. That was great. You can sing that with you. We ought to start as a band.
Get on the road.
That'd be a good idea, Ricky. I believe I could help out a little.
Yeah, boy. Get on the radio.
I believe Uncle Earl cranks this one off. I've been all around this whole wide world. Love old Memphis, Tennessee. Any old place I hang my hat, it seems like home to me. Oh, don't let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down. Oh, Lordy, don't let your deal go down. All the last old dollars gone. Make it, Ricky. Sweet love at home, she's standing in the door. She threw her little arms around my neck and said, sweet daddy, please don't go. Oh, don't let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down. Sweet baby, don't let your deal go down. Oh, but let your dollars go. Where did you get them high heel shoes? That dress you wear so fine. Got my shoes from a railroad man. Got my dress from a driver in the mine. There went my deal. But don't let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down. For my last old dollar. Thank you, folks. Thank you, thank you. Folks, I'm just as informal as I would be if you were in my house. And I think Earl and Ricky are, too.
That's the very man right over there that made me fall in love with guitar, Mr. Earl Scruggs.
Yeah, man.
I loved his banjo playing, but I sure loved his guitar playing. And nobody plays guitar like Earl. Well, you know, one of the great things about listening to old-time radio back in the 50s when I was born
sprout all what?
Just well, a sprout.
Yeah.
I got to play on their TV show when I was 7, so I
he
started
sure
young.
Did.
I had a lot of bills to pay. I got to hear these radio shows, early morning radio shows, WSM, Martha White, and my God, it was worth getting up for. You know, it was worth getting up and listening to them play and sing, and it just got your day started. You know, get your heart pumping, get you ready for school, and it was great. And used to love the old quartets. You know, and we're gonna do one right now for you. And my buddy Paul Brewster's back here. He's gonna sing with us. This is called "Who Will Sing for Me." Oft I sing
for my friends. When death's cold hand I see, when I reach my journey's end, who will sing one song for me? I wonder who will sing for me when I'm called to cross that silent sea.
Come up to me and say,
"Rick, I like that old banjo you play there, buddy."
So I don't play banjo, really.
Yeah, you do.
I said, "No, I don't.
I've seen you."
So they are going to be seeing me tonight. So, but I love the old clawhammer style banjo, the old mountain style, and I guess, Earl, did any of your relatives play old clawhammer style
banjo?
Yeah,
I had two brothers and two sisters.
And they both played the clawhammer style.
They could do that, and I couldn't hit a lick on it like that. My fingers won't wiggle when I bend
well,
the wrist.
Them wiggling fingers is what made you rich. Yeah, so. And what made us happy.
Yeah. It worked out real well for. I'll tell a little story how that came about. Yeah. I was playing this Reuben tune down in D tune, and suddenly realized I had this roll going. It came to me like that.
Wow.
And I played that same tune the rest of the week. My oldest brother, Junie, he'd come over on Saturday, and I couldn't wait for him to hear me pick. He came walking up the road, and I got out on the edge of the porch picking. And every once in a while, I see him turn his head one side. He was getting a little drift with it. He picked, came on up through the yard, up steps, and as he started in the house, he said, "Is that all you know?"
I know the feeling, brother.
You do?
Yes, sir.
But that's where the three-fingered style, that's where that you got the... came to you there.
Sitting in what we call the living room.
The front room.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, we're going to do the clawhammer banjo and then that wiggling thing that he does.
I like to play with somebody playing clawhammer, and Ricky does a tremendous job. Let me hear you, Ricky. Yeah.
Soldier's joy.
That's the way I'd pick.
If I was going to play three-finger, that's the way I'd pick. How were the first time you heard the Monroe Brothers?
Well, we had a little wind-up. We called it a graphophone in the house. And one of my older brothers came home with a record, and he said, I want you to listen to this. It's some of the best I've ever heard. Put that on that thing, and... The first thing he played, I believe, was this song right here. It was called, What is Home Without Love? Sad and alone in a mansion, no loving heart to caress. Sad a man, sad and lonely, no loving wife's lips to kiss. She married him for a position, no love in her heart had she. Sad and lost in his fine home, he looked all around him and said, what is a home without a baby? Just the love and the tease and the door. What is a home without a sweet wife to kiss you each night at the door? What is a home without sunshine to spread its bright rays from above? You may have wealth and its pleasures, but what is a home without love? Street one evening, he passed by a cottage so neat. Then he stopped and looked in a window and saw there a picture so sweet. A husband, a wife, and a baby just hugging and kissing too. He stepped aside, his tears to hide,
and from his lips came these words. What is a home without a baby? Just a love and a tease and a door. What is a home without a sweet wife to kiss you each night at the door? What is a home without sunshine to spread its bright rays from above? You can have wealth and its pleasures, but what is a home without love?
What is a home without love?
Welcome, Miss Alison Krauss.
And look at you.
I think they're glad you're here.
Let's do a good old Carter family tune here, Ricky.
All right.
Something called Storms on the Ocean. I'll kind of give you a little short kickoff on this. Going away for to leave you, love. I'm going away for a while. But I'll return to you sometime if I go 10,000 miles. The storms aren't on the ocean, and the heavens may cease to be. This world may lose its motion, love, if I prove false to thee. Honey, who will glove your hands? And who will kiss your sweet, sweet lips when I'm in a far-off land? Papa will shoe my pretty little feet. Mama will glove my hands. You can kiss my rosy lips when you come back again. The storms aren't on the ocean, and the heavens may cease to be. This world may lose its motion, love, if I prove false to thee. Oh, see that lonesome little dove as he flies from pine to pine. He's mourning for his own true love, just the way I mourn for mine. I'll not go back on the ocean, love. I'll never go back to sea. And I won't turn my back on my blue-eyed girl, lest she goes back on me. Storms aren't on the ocean, and the heavens may cease to be. This world may lose its motion, love, if I prove false to thee. The storms aren't on the ocean, and the heavens may cease to be. This world may lose its motion, love, if I prove false to thee.
Oh, that was fun, Doc.
thought it would be appropriate to have Alison sing on this one, since she was so important to the Oh Brother soundtrack and sang this song in the movie. And Doc also sang this song, and I guess...
That's where they got it.
Yeah, that's where they got the tune, was from you, so I guess it's your fault.
I learned it from my grandmother.
Well, it sounds like a mighty, mighty old song that still has a lot of life to it. And this is going to be fun. This is Down in the Valley to Pray.
As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Come on, fathers, and let's go down. Come on down, don't you want to go down? Come on, fathers, and let's go down, down in the valley to pray. As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Come on, mothers, and let's go down. Come on down, don't you want to go down? Come on, mothers, and let's go down, down in the valley to pray. As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Come on, brothers, and let's go down. Come on down, don't you want to go down? Come on, brothers, and let's go down, down in the valley to pray. As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Come on, sisters, and let's go down. Come on down, don't you want to go down? Come on, sisters, let's go down, down in the valley to pray. As I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Come on, sinners, and let's go down. Come on down, don't you want to go down? Come on, sinners, and let's go down, down in the valley to pray.
Mighty pretty.
That's great, Doc. Doc, that's mighty fine. I'm glad you sat down and listened to your grandmother.
I used to hear a churn and sing that on the porch, and the words just sort of fell into my head, you know.
Wasn't that old slobby butter fine around that handle?
Tell me about that, son, with a big old piece of that homemade bread.
Oh, Lord.
I asked my love take a walk just a little ways with me. As we walked and we would talk all about our wedding day. Darling, say that you'll be mine in our home. Pretty white hand, led her down that bank of sand. I pushed her in where she would drown. Lord, I saw her as she floated down. Darling,
say that you'll be mine. In our home we'll happy be, down beside where the waters flow, on the banks of the Ohio. Returning home between 12 and 1, thinking, Lord, Lord, what a deed I've done. I killed the girl I love, you see, because she would not marry me. Darling, say that you'll be mine. In our home we'll happy be, side where the waters flow, on the banks of the Ohio. Next day at 4:30, the sheriff walked right to my door. He said, young man, don't try to run, you must pay for this awful crime you've done. Darling, say that you'll be mine. In our side where the waters flow, on the banks of the Ohio.
Thank you, Alison. Thank you, Mark.
Bluegrass music.
that old time. You know, one of the great things that I used to love to hear Earl Scruggs and Paul Warren and Benny Martin and people like that, different fiddle players that they had, they would do a fiddle and banjo thing. It was just the best. And so Glenn is going to start off here. Him and Earl are going to do a little thing called Katy Hill, and then we're going to jump in and mash on it. So much, I tell you. Doc, this is just the best bunch of folks you ever seen over here in Carolina.
Oh, they'll do, won't they?
Yeah, they'll do.
Well, folks at home will wish when they see this that they'd have been here with us in Winston-Salem tonight. You know what? Hey, Doc, how about a little Foggy Mountain Top? You think that'd be a good one?
Here we go.
Sail away to the west. I'd sail all around this whole wide world to the girl I love the best.
If I had listened to what Mama said, I would not be here today, lying around this old jailhouse, weeping my sweet life away.
If I was on some foggy mountain top, I'd sail away to the west. I'd sail all around this whole wide world to the girl I love the best.
Pick it, Earl.
Whenever you see that girl, something you can tell her, she need not to fool no time away just to court some other feller. She calls me to weep, she calls me to mourn, she calls me to leave my home. To them lonesome pines and them good old times, I'm on my way back home now. If I was on some foggy mountain top, I'd sail away to the west. I'd sail all around this whole wide world to the girl I love.
boys, I'll tell you how to do. Pull off that long tail roustabout, put on your navy blue. If I was on some market mountain top, I'd sail away to the west. I'd sail all around this whole wide world to the girl I love the best.
Everybody pick one.
Fine, boys. It was the best thing I'd been involved with in a long time. I don't know if I'd ever been involved with anything that would come up with it.
Someday we'll look back at this and we'll know, you know, that history was made that night. Three people sat down to just pick.
That jam session, I'll call it, on the stage at Mendel's Auditorium that night was like a good jam session at home. I forgot everything but pick. It was a wonderful thing.
Thank you, folks. We appreciate it so much.
Thank you, folks. Lord bless you all.